Hello students, welcome to my channel. Let us discuss one mark section of GATE 2019 Agriculture and Engineering. So there are 25 questions under this category, and this is a mix of agricultural engineering and mathematics, basically mathematics plus farm machinery and power, then soil and water conservation plus irrigation, agriculture processing and dairy food engineering. Everything is incorporated, so all the questions from one mark section, so 25 marks all total. So let us discuss question by question, what is the solution of each question. So first of all, question number 1, so integration of dx by x square plus 1 whole square, so integration from 0 to infinite. So here actually first you have to find out the integral of this one. So we know that integral, let us just solve it. So I is equal to, that is 0 to infinite dx by x square plus 1 whole square. So here if you see that x is tan theta and dx will be equal to sec square d theta. So by using the partial differentiation and integration, so we can have I will be equal to, so that is 0 to infinite, that is sec square theta d theta divided by 1 tan square theta plus 1. So here if you see tan square theta is equal to you can say plus 1 will be equal to sec square theta. So putting this one, so I will be equal to 0 to infinite sec square theta d theta divided by sec square theta square. Cancel. So then cancelling, so it will be sec square theta, so therefore it will be 0 to infinite cos square theta d theta. So here it's very simple. So also you know cos 2 theta will be equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. So therefore cos square theta is equal to cos 2 theta plus 1 divided by 2. So therefore putting there, so we can say I will be equal to half 0 to infinite integration, so cos 2 theta d theta plus d theta by 2. It's very simple. So theta is a function, so theta we have taken 10x, 10 inverse x you can say, so that will be equal to 1 by 4 sine 2 theta plus half theta plus c 0 to infinite. So this is the limit. So we know that x we have taken 10 theta, and therefore theta will be equal to 10 inverse x or arc 10x. So therefore the integration will be equal to, putting the values together, so it will be x by 2 into 1 plus x square again plus half 10 inverse x. So this is very simple. So 0 to infinite. If you put infinite here, this will become 0, and this one will become 10x, 10 inverse 10x, that is infinite will be pi by 2. So therefore the answer will be pi by 4, and 0 will be 0 everywhere, so infinite will be 0, so pi by 4 will be answer. So pi by 4 is equal to 0.785. so therefore if you see, so the answer for this question will be 0.785. this is the option, that is A is the option. Next question, question number 2. So question number 2 says to find out the determinant of matrix A that is given. So we know matrix, if any matrix, let us see A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, let it be three matrix. So that in determinant, let it be A, will be equal to A into, that is remaining E, F, H, I minus B into that is D, F, and g I plus c into DE and GH. So very simple, then it will be E, then I minus ST, then DI minus GF, DH minus G, something like that. So therefore here if you see, the determinant will be 2 into 3 into 1 minus 2 into 2 minus 1 into 2 into 1 minus 2 into 1 plus 1 into 2 into 2 minus 3 into 1. So therefore the answer will be 2, which is minus 2 minus 0 plus 1. So that will be equal to minus 1. So therefore the answer will be minus 1, which is C. So therefore the answer will be C for this question. Next question, in a relay race there are 5 teams A, B, C, D, E. Assuming that each team has an equal chance of securing any position, this is first, second or third, third, fourth, fifth, whatever in the race. So then the probability that A, B, C finish first, second, third respectively will be half this. So let us see, first of all total number of teams are 5 and only 3 teams will win. So basically 3 teams will win either first or second or third, and therefore the total number of order will be, so let us say total number of orders will be equal to 5 divided by 5 minus 3. So that is factor, 5 factor by 5.5 minus 3, so that will be equal to 5 into 4 into 3 divided by into 2 into 1 divided by 2 into 1, so that will be equal to 60. So that will be 60. So therefore that is the number of orders, that is related NS. And that is single event where actually A, B and C will finish first or second. So event in which A is first, B is second and C is third. So first, second, third, first, second and third. So that will be event related E1, E. That is probability of that event will be equal to related PL. So L event. So therefore related NL, that is number of event, only once it will be there, so therefore it will be only one. So we can only once 1, 2, 3 can be there. So therefore the probability of the event, that is L, NL will be equal to NL divided by total of order NS. So that will be equal to 1 by 60. So therefore the probability of that A, B, C finish first, second and third will be equal to 1 by 60. So therefore this is the answer, 1 by 60 is A. So answer is A. Question number 4. The path traced by the material traced between the cylinder and the concave of an axial flow through a tracer is straight, single pass, no, curved. So if you see, this is a axial flow concave tracer. So here you see, if this is the input to the, or you can say the prop is fed here and it passes axially through a helical path, and many times it is traced, you can see here. If you see straight single pass, no, it's not the answer. Curved and perpendicular to the cylinder shaft ke saath perpendicular, nahi, this is not correct. So this is the cylinder shaft and this is perpendicular, so this is not proper. And helical and several times, this is helical way, you can see here. So therefore the answer will be there. And D, straight and parallel to the cylinder shaft, no. So aise bhi nahi hai. So only this is the correct answer. So therefore the C will be answer for this question. Next question, question number 5. The farm machine or implement used only for preparing wetland is rotavator, disc harrow, hydro tiller, cultivator. So if you see the rotavator, that works in dry soil, disc harrow also in dry soil, hydro tiller is like this. So hydro means water related to tilling the mud, so therefore this is hydro tiller and cultivator. So among these, only hydro tiller works in wetland, so therefore the answer will be C. This is question number 5. Next question, question number 6. The type of typical spray distribution profile of a hollow cone nozzle is steep sided slope, gradual sloping, narrow stopped, narrow topped with steep sides. So if you see, these are different pattern of the different nozzles. So first the flat fin, so uniformly maintained, both two, these are solid cone and this one is hollow cone nozzle. So therefore the pattern looks like this. So here if you see, the steep sided slope are for the hollow cone nozzle. So here this slope is steep and if you see here, this is the pattern and in between there is no spray in the middle. Therefore, the answer will be steep sided slope. So answer will be A for this question. Next question, that is question number 7. The amount of biogas required to run a diesel engine is 0.65 meter cube per kilowatt per hour. The minimum size of the Dinbandhu model biogas plant in meter cube required to run a 1 kilowatt diesel engine daily for 1 hour. So here the power 1 kilowatt and time is 1 hour. So that means 1 kilowatt hour will be there. So if you see the biogas required for 1 kilowatt hour, if you see this one, so that is 0.65 meter cube. So that means daily gas requirement is 0.65 meter cube. So to meet the 0.65 meter cube, you have to design this Dinbandhu gas model, where actually the digester volume, total volume of the digester, you have to find out. That is minimum size required for the Dinbandhu model. So how to find out? Because 1 kg of cow dung produces 0.04 meter cube of gas. So therefore, how much kg of cow dung required? That is 0.65 divided by 0.04 meter cube, that is meter cube of, because 1 kg is 1 liter, let it be. So this is the volume required and 40 days you have to keep it. Therefore, this is multiplied by 40 and into 2, because 1:1 ratio, the cow dung and water is to mixed. Therefore, this is the total volume. So it comes around 1.3 meter cube. So if you see 1.3 meter cube, so definitely you have to divide by 1000. So in this case, so then it will be 1.3 meter cube required. So again, this is the slurry volume. So and the gas holder, gas has to be holded. So therefore 50% of that total, let it be 0.65 or 0.6, then total will be equal to around 1.95 or equal to 2 meter. 2 meter cube is required for the total volume of the digester. Therefore, this is the minimum size of the Dinbandhu model gas in meter cube is required to run 1 kilowatt diesel engine for daily basis. So therefore, the answer will be 2, or this is the answer. Next question, it is question number 8. A soil sample has a porosity of 40%, void ratio of the soil sample is dash. So basically, if you see, this is the soil and solids and voids. So VB is the volume of voids and VS is the volume of solids. So therefore, we know, so void ratio, let it E, that is equal to VB by VS, and porosity, let it N, that is equal to VB by V, total volume, V, so VB by V plus VB plus VS, we can write down. And also we can divide by VS, divide by VB by VS plus VS by VS. So that will be equal to VB by VS is E, so therefore E by 1 plus E. So porosity is given, that is N, so we equal to 0.2, it's given. So therefore, so keeping that is 1 plus E into 0.2, we can make it E will be equal to 2 by 3, which is equivalent to 0.667. So this is the answer for this question. So therefore, the answer will be D. Next question. In the Muskingum method of channel routing, the routing equation is written as Q dot Q naught will equal to C naught I2 plus C1 I1 plus C2 Q1. If the storage time constant K is given, so in this case, K is 12 hour and X factor is given 0.15. And time difference that is given as 4 hour. So we know the coefficient C dot. So C naught is equal to, we know, minus Kx plus 0.5 del T divided by, this is the formula, K into 1 minus X plus 0.5 del T. So putting everything into place, that is minus 12 into 0.15 plus 0.5 into 4 divided by minus 12 into 1 minus 0.15 plus 0.5 into 4. So putting the calculating the value, the C0 will be equal to 0.016. Therefore the answer will be A, that is 0.016. So next question, this is the matching type. Question number 10, match the following items between column 1 and 2 with the most appropriate combination. So here actually about the contour lines, so uniform speed contours, space contours first. So if you see the contour lines, if this is uniformly spaced, then there will be definitely uniform slope. Uniform spaced means uniform slope, very simple. This is like this one, here you can see. So they are uniformly distributed, this side. So therefore, 1 will be equal to S. Wildly spaced contour, so therefore like this side. So that means wildly contoured. So therefore, that will be equal to flat ground, almost flat. If this will be more, then this will be like flat ground. Closely spaced contour, that means this one will be very more close space. Contour means steep slope will be there. Therefore, that will be steep ground. So like this. And a series of closed contours, series means like this. So that means there is a hilly area. So therefore, 4 will be R. So therefore, if you see 1S, 2P, 3Q. So 1S, 2P, 3Q and 4R. So therefore the answer will be B. Next question. Question number 11. Tensiometer installed in the soil measures osmotic suction of soil moisture, soil permeability, soil moisture content. Definitely it measures soil moisture content, but indirectly. So directly it measures actually the potential of the soil, that is metric potential of the soil. It includes the capillary potential of the soil. So therefore the answer will be actually the capillary potential of the soil. The answer will be D in this case. Remember, the soil moisture content, it definitely measures, but it measures actually the capillary potential of the soil. Next question. Head pulley of a bucket elevator has an effective radius of 150 mm. In order to obtain the most adequate discharge from the elevator, speed of the head pulley in RPM will be less. So if you see the head pulley in the bucket elevator, so it generally lifts the grains. So grain has to be delivered here. Let it be see the delivery. Here it is the input, this is the output, you can say. So when it is delivered, certain velocity has to be there. You can see how it throws, the throwing velocity, you can say. That throwing velocity is important. So therefore, according to the theory, so optimum throwing discharge velocity, you can say, discharge velocity of elevator is required. This means how much the velocity will be there. So you can say Vt. So that Vt is how much it should be. There should be, basically the according to the theory, it should be 1.2 m/s. So this is the actual velocity it requires, and it is given that this pulley, this pulley radius is given. That is radius of the head pulley. So radius of head pulley is given, which is 150 mm. So therefore the diameter will be equal to 300 mm or is equal to 0.3 m. Now since the diameter is 0.3 m, so the velocity, that means velocity of the peripheral velocity is equal to, you know, pi dn by 60. Since we have to find out the RPM of the head pulley, so n is the RPM, therefore d is the diameter of the pulley. So this is the velocity, it is to through, so that it will be effectively delivered, optimum velocity should be there. So therefore putting this 1.2 will be equal to pi into 0.3 pi dn, n is required to find out due to 60. So therefore n will be equal to, or rpm of the head pulley will be equal to 76.4 rpm, or in the option there were 74.6 is not there, so d is here, that is 77. So therefore the answer will be 77. Next question, question number 13. The clean paddy production per annum is 160 million tons. Average milling quality analysis indicates the husk content, total yield and degree of pulley is 22.22%, 73.32% and 6% respectively. For an average bran oil yield of 20%, the annual rice bran oil potential in million ton is dash. So here actually little trick is given. So as we know, paddy when it is milled, so it produces bran, husk and rice. So if you see, husk is generally is some percentage is there. Here it is given 22% it contains. Then it is also saying the rice, actually rice plus bran, some bran actually goes to the rice. So rice generally after the polishing, the polishing is percentage is given, that means a grain which contains the bran all over the rice, some portion is detached, then this is called the bran, others are remaining this one. So polishing percentage is 6, here its polish percentage is 6, that means 6% still remains in that one, 6% of the total bran, so the total area. So we will not into this 6%, straightforward the bran husk is given 22% rice, then bran, remaining bran is very important, that is the you can say production of the bran. So rice or yield, you can say net yield given, so net yield which contains some of the bran, so that is given as 73.2%. So rest bran is produced, that means the bran produced will be 100 minus 22 plus 73.2. so basically this is a very important, 6% is not important. So therefore the percentage of bran which is found produced, that is equal to how much, that is 4.68%. So 4.68% of 160 million ton bran is produced. So and each the bran contains 20% oil, so that means we can say how much total oil, so or you can say the what potential of oil, bran oil potential we can find out, that will be equal to bran contents is 4.68 divided 100 definitely into 160 million ton into 20%, that is 0.2, 20% is 0.2. so therefore the answer will be equal to 1.498 million ton. So this is the answer for this question. So the annual rice bran oil potential in million ton is equal to 1.498, which is the answer for this question. Next question, question 14. A batch of 10,000 liter milk is to be sterilized in, therefore packed in 20,000 packets of 500 milliliter each. The mean standard plate count of Bacillus subtilis, that is bacteria, in 100 samples of fresh milk was found to be 50 per milliliter. The milk is to be sterilized such that 500 milliliter packet is completely devoid of the same organism. Here you have to find out the minimum number of log cycle reduction for the sterilization. It's a again it's a very tricky question. So here first of all you have to find out the sample. Here actually the load or number of bacteria, number of subtilis, you can say in raw milk, find out karna hai for packet. Jo finally humara 10,000 liter of milk, raw milk is produced to number of packets, so that is around 20,000 packets. So 20,000 packet of 500 ml. So that means if you see this raw milk, if you pack into 500 milliliter, then actually the raw milk contains 50 into 500 per packet. Okay, so that means 2.5 into 10 to the power 4 bacteria. So that is N0, the number of bacteria for sample, you can say. So we have to find out the sample. So this, that means 2.5 into 10 to the power 4 bacteria are initially present. So it has to be reduced in a such a level that, so that means there is no bacteria. No bacteria means 20,000 samples are there. So out of the 20,000 sample, per sample is this much. Initially, final sample will be less than 1. So that means no means less than 1. In 20,000, total 20,000, there is should be 1. So that means the n final number will be equal to 1 by 20,000. So that means this is the log reduction value. So that, that will be equal to 2 into 10 to the power, so sorry, 5 into 10 to the power, how much? 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. So this is the number of bacteria should be present in the sample, that is the one packet. So therefore N0 is 2.5 into 10 to the power 4 and N is equal to 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. So therefore we know the sterilizing value or log cycle required sterilizing value or log cycle reduction, that will be equal to log n 0 by n. So here log n0 is 2.5 into 10 to the power 4, that is n is 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. So if you calculate, the value will be equal to, d value will be equal to 8.7 around, which is equivalent to 9. So therefore according to this question, the minimum number of log cycle reduction for sterilization of this batch will be equal to 9. So therefore the answer will be B. So next question is question number 15. This says a tube in tube counter flow heat exchanger is heating oil from 35 degrees Celsius to 77 degrees Celsius by circulating hot water at 100 degrees. The outlet temperature of water is 70 degrees and the log mean temperature difference is there. Four statements are given. Let us first calculate the LMTD by finding that it is saying the hot water is flowing from 100 degrees to 70 degrees Celsius and cold water from 35 to 77 degrees Celsius. So it's a counter one, so they will run opposite to each other counterclockwise. So in this case, this is the difference from 70 to 35. This is this side 100 to 77. So LMTD we know, LMTD value will be equal to that is n difference, that is one is 70 minus 35 minus 100 minus 77, that side divided by ln, that is 70 minus 35 divided by 100 minus 77. So that will, that value will be calculated as 28.58 degrees Celsius. Now it is saying that it is exactly equal to the mean arithmetic temperature difference. So you have to find out the mean arithmetic temperature difference. So mean arithmetic temperature, MATD let it be. So that will be equal to mean arithmetic means temperature difference this side and that side. So this side is the difference is 70 minus 35. Plus that side is 100 minus 77 divided by 2. So this is very arithmetic mean, very simple. So that will be equal to 29 degrees Celsius. So if you see 29 and 28.58, so they are not exactly equal, but significantly greater, not significantly greater or not significantly smaller, but it's very nearly equal to the mean arithmetic. So so the options D is clearly matching, that is very nearly equal but not exactly equal or exactly or smaller or greater. If you can say 28.58 and 29, so very little difference is there. So therefore the answer will be D for this question. So next question is question number 16. Using trapezoidal rule, the value of integration of 0.4 ln x from 4 to 5.2 rounded up decimal place. So x and y is given here. So it's very simple using the trapezoidal rule. If you see in trapezoidal rule, so x0 is the initial point and xn is this one. So x1, x2, x3, whatever. So many points are there. In this case, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points are there. x2, x3, x4, and x5. Related 4 points are there. xn is the last one. So if you see the difference between x0 minus x, or you can say x1 minus x0. In this case, you give 4.2 minus 4, that is 0.2. And therefore, the very simple formula, that is 0.2 divided 2 into, if you say the initial and final, that is x0 plus xn. So in this case, plus 2 into, so x1 plus x2 up to xn minus 1 in this case. And this one is x1 minus x2, sorry, x2 minus x1 by this one, 0.2 in this case. So therefore, putting the values together, there is 0.2 divided 2 into, say, x0 and xn. And this one is here, sorry, this is y0, y1. So y1, y2, yn. So this one, so the integration will be equal to this one. There is area under curve you have to find out. So that will be equal to y0. So in this case, y0 is first one, that is 1.386, and final one, yn, is last one, that is 1.648 plus 2 into rest, that is 1.435 plus 1.482 plus 1.526 plus 1.569 plus 1.609. So then you have to calculate everything. Just then it will be, value is 1.2828 the value. So according to this question, the answer will be 1.828. So this is very simple one to find out the integration or area under the curve, any curve. So ln x in this case is given, so you have to find out. Next question, that is question number 17. Two cards are drawn in a random and without replacement from a pack of 52 playing cards. The probability that both the cards are black, rounded up the three decimal place. So here in this case, so if a card, pack of cards, you can say playing card, contains 52 number of cards, we know out of 52 numbers, either it's black or red. If you see any, so black, red, so that means 26 is black and 26 is red. Okay, so in this case, so both are independent event. First is drawn, then second is drawn without replacing that one. Therefore, both the events are independent of each other. So first, related first card, probability of drawing black. So how much? Then because since it contains 26 black and 26 red, so total is 52 and 26 red. So therefore, the probability will be 26 by 52. So let it probability of black 1 first. Then second time, the second card of drawing is black again, but first card is not replaced. So therefore, first card not replaced means there will be 51 cards total now left, and one black is already black, so therefore 25 is black. So therefore, the probability of second card is black, that will be equal to 25 divided by 51. So that is, since the both the events are independent to each other, so therefore the probability that both the cards are black, so probability of both cards are black, that is, let it P, B and B will be equal to P B1 into P B2. Probability of 1, 1, 2, so the probability 1 is 26 by 52 and probability 2 is 25 by 51. So the total will be equal to 0.245. So this is the answer, that is probability that both the cards are black will be equal to 0.245. So therefore, the answer is 0.245. So next question, question number 18. The total width between the two extreme furrows openers in a tractor drawn 9-row wheat seed drill is 1.6 meter. The average mass of wheat seeds Drought per meter of row length in each four opener is 2.15 gram. Seed rate obtained with this seed drill will be how much? So basically, if you see, this is a 9-row seed drill. So if you see, it is saying the total width between two estimates. So if you see, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So let me open this. There is 9. So 9 from its, if you see 9, so this end to this end, the total width is given, that is 1.6 meter. So if you see 9 is there, so this means there means how much gap is there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 gaps are there. That means, so the strip will be 8. Therefore, the credit width is 1.6 meter and number of furrow is related 9. So therefore, the row-to-row spacing or strip spacing will be W by N minus 1. In this case, that will be equal to 1.6 divided by 9 minus 1, that is 1.6 by 8, that is 0.2 meter. So if you see, each strip has a spacing of 0.2 meter. This is very important. Then it's given, S is the spacing. Now, the weight, that means if it is operated, so this strip per meter, 1 meter of each strip, let it be 1 meter into 0.2. So one area will be 1 meter by 0.2 meter. So this area, how much seed is contained? That is 2.15 gram, which is equivalent to 2.15 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg. So that kg is throughout this area 1 meter by 2 meter. So that means you can say seed rate, you can say seed rate will be equal to seed in divided area, very simple, or seed into area. So seed into area, in this case, that is seed is 2.15 into 10 to the power minus 3 kg upon area is 1 meter by 0.2 meter. This is meter square is there. So now to make it 10 to the power minus 4 hectare. So because this is hectare per meter square. So meter square is cancelled out. So hectare will be there. So therefore the seed rate will be equal to 107.5 kg per hectare. So this is the answer in this case, that is 107.5 is the answer for this question. So next question, question number 19. The purchase price of a tractor is rupees 5,50,000. Useful life of the tractor is 10 years. And its salvage value is 10% of the purchase price. Following the sum of the years digit method, the depreciation in third year in rupees is days. So here it is given L. L is the life of the tractor is 10 years. Then purchase price related P is given 5,50,000. Then S is 10% of the purchase price. So 10%. Is equal to 0.1 into purchase price, that means 1.1p. Now you have to use the sum of the year digit method. Sum of the year means total 10. So sum of the years, let it yd, that will be equal to l into l plus 1 by 2. This is l is given 10 into 11 by 2, that is 55 years. 55, sum of the digit. Now since this is third year, you have to find out in third year. So that means n plus 1, let it be 3. Okay. So therefore, D or depreciation in n plus 1 year will be equal to, we know, L minus N by YD into P minus S. So here L is 10, N is 3. So n is 2, sorry, in this case, because this is 2 plus 1 is 3, third year you have to find out. So therefore 10 minus 2 divided by 55 into p is 5,50,000 minus 1, sorry, p minus 0.1p, so into 0.9 you can multiply, because another 0. Okay, so this is the thing, so you have to solve it, so then it will be equal to 72,000. Straightforward, you will find. So this is the depreciation in the year 3. So So this is, remember, this is n plus 1 you have to see. This is here actually only you have to 2 you have to take instead of 3. This is a mistake someone makes somewhere when you calculate in the third year. Next question, that is question number 20. So a pair of bullock, a pair of stray teeth for gear is transmitting power at 500 rpm. The pinion has 16 standard full depth involute teeth of module 80 millimeter. So here very simple, if you see the spur gear, any gear when it matches mates with another gear, the module has to be same. So here the module is given. So module already we know, that is a pitch dia, or you can say pitch dia or D will be equal to module into, module is AM rated B into number of teeth. Number of teeth, that is T rated B. In this case, module is given as 8 millimeter and T, number of teeth is given as 16. So therefore, the pitch dia, or this one is the pitch dia, you can see from this to this. So this is the pitch dia where actually contact takes place from this point to this point. From this point to this diameter. So D is equal to 8 into 16. That is in millimeter. Will be equal to 8 into 16 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. That will be diameter of the this pitch diameter. Now pitch velocity it has asked. So therefore diameter is known, pitch velocity you have to find out. So here actually the RPM, that is N, is given 500. So therefore the pitch velocity Vp let it be, pitch velocity will be equal to pi dn by 60 again. So pi into d is 8 into 16 into 10 to the minus 3 divided into 500 divided 60, because it's RPM. So that, therefore the answer will be 3.35 meter per second. So it is asked to find out in meter per second. So therefore the answer will be 3.35. Next question, question number 21. A soil conservation structure has an expected life of 10 years and is designed for a flood magnitude of return of 50 years. The risk is, you have to find out the risk. So very simple, the risk is calculated where actually it can break. So that is 1 minus 1 minus 1 by t to the power n into 100. So percentage of risk. So here actually t is the time period, that is in this case it's given 50. So return period, you can say flood return period is 50 years and n is 10 years. So n is 10 years, therefore putting the values, that is r will be equal to 1 minus 1 minus 1 by 50 to the power 10 into 100. The value will be equal to 18.29. So therefore the there is a percentage of risk is 18.29%. So next question, the question number 22, that is a watershed of area 80 hectare has a runoff coefficient of 0.3. A storm of intensity 5 cm per hour occurs for a duration more than the time of concentration of the watershed. So basically the, there is a time of concentration more than that one, means whatever the discharge will coming, that will come into the peak discharge. Here if you see, there is a base flow is given. So for example, since duration is more than time of concentration, C is given, that is the runoff coefficient is 0.3 and area is 80 hectare, and I, the intensity of rainfall is given, that is 5 centimeter per hour. So we know the peak discharge is equal to CIA by 36, since C is in, there is a coefficient, I is in centimeter per hour, A is the hectare. So if you see this thing, so quickly you can solve it, that is equal to 0.3 into 5 into 80 divided by 36. So straightforward, the answer will be 3.33. It's very simple, the area from which the runoff comes, area into intensity, that is centimeter per hour, for 1 hour, how much the rainfall or star, and so that means you can easily calculate. Here actually there is no base flow or anything, so big peak discharge will be equal to this much. So peak discharge will be CIA by 360. So the answer will be 3.33 meter cube per second. So it's very simple here. 5 is centimeter per hour, and this is hectare, and 360 is for, there is hectare to meter square, and hour to second. So if you multiply, then you can calculate. Next question, there is a lateral has 12 sprinklers spaced 14 meter apart. In a sprinkler irrigation system, the lateral are spaced 20 meter apart on the main line. If the recommended fertilizer dose is given, so it's very simple. Again, the area of the sprinkler system, you have to find out the number of sprinkler latitude 1, 2, 3, whatever. So here is 14. So 12 sprinklers, so 12 into spacing is 14. And the lateral spacing is given at 20. So total, this is the area. So area is meter square, and convert into hectare, you have to multiply by 10 to the power minus per hectare. So this is the area under which the lateral, the system has to be operated. Then the dose is given. So dose is 80 kg per hectare. So this is a hectare, so 80 kg per hectare. So very simple. So dose into area. So dose into area is the amount required. So amount required will be equal to, that is a dose into area. So dose is this one, 80 into area is 12 into 14 into 20 into 10 to the power minus 4. So the answer will be straightforward, that is 26.68 kg. So this is the requirement, amount required to have a dose of this one. So the answer will be 26.68. Next question. Question number 24. In a rubber wool cellar, 250 millimeter diameter rolls are set at a clearance of 1 millimeter. If the mean thickness of paddy grain spring stall cell is 2 millimeter, the length of the husking zone is how much? So this is the rubber roll cellar, and if you see, the two rollers are there, in between some gap is here. So gap is 1 millimeter, and the paddy is 2 millimeter. So that means if you see this triangle, so let it O A B, then this is C, this is D. So let it this triangle, according to this, this, so from this to this, the base initially is 125, 250 millimeter, the diameter is 250 millimeter, so the radius will be equal to 125 millimeter. So this one, from this to this, OB, which is called OB, which is 2 R, and if you see, so when the grain comes, so it is actually places in between these two. So basically this is 1 and this is 1, 0.5 this side and 0.5 this side. So therefore, so the OC, let it be, OC will be equal to 125 minus 1 by 2. So that is 124.5 millimeter. So this is 124.5 millimeter. So now, if you see, this is R. Up to this, this is R, up to this, this point. Then this is latitude theta. So if you see, on the triangle O, let it, ODC, ODC triangle, R is equal to, that is OD, that is equal to 125. And if you see R cos theta and R sin theta, you have to find out. First of all, R cos theta. R cos theta is equal to this, from O, OC, which is equal to 124.5. Therefore, R is 124. So 125 cos theta is equal to 124.5. So therefore, cos theta is equal to 124.5 by 125. So this is the thing. Same, if you see, R sin theta is equal to this one. This, from this point where actually the touch is happening, this one. This is DC. DC, which is equivalent to R. R is 125 and sine theta. So how to find out sine theta? Sine theta is related to theta, is this one 174.5 by 125, cos inverse. So this, that is equal to theta is 5.13 degree. From there actually, then R sin theta will be 125 into sin 5.13. So this is one side. Then other side, if you see from this to this, this is the length of the husking zone. So therefore, two multiply, so that will be husking zone length of the husking zone will be 2 into 125 into sin 5.3. So therefore, calculating this one, you can calculate it's 22.34 millimeter. So everything is millimeters. Therefore, the answer, that is the length of the husking zone in millimeter, will be equal to 22.34 millimeter. So next question, around question number 25, the air water vapor mixture at 1 atmosphere pressure has 0.035 kg water vapor. That means H is given. H is 0.035 kg vapor. Now that is per kg dry air, and temperature, the dry bulb temperature given T is 37 degrees Celsius, which is equivalent to, so you have to use the in the formula. So the humid volume VH, there is a formula, that is 0.00283 plus 0.00456 H into T plus 273, that is Kelvin. So this is a very simple formula you have to use here. So there is no need to use the R, universal gas constant. So humid volume air, the simple formula you have to use. So that will be equal to 0.00283 plus 0.00456 into H is 0.035 multiply into T is 37 plus 273, then calculating this value you can get, that is 0.927 meter cube per kg dry air. So this is the answer for this question. So that is the 0.927 answer. So this is the end of the 1 mark section. There is 25 questions there. So hope you understand everything. Please like and subscribe to my channel.